Hello guys, welcome to More Life is Strange Before Storm Episode 2, continuing where we left off from last, so just want a quick warning, this game has been glitching out on me, so sorry if we have any trouble, I'm not looking forward to it. So.
Soon. Well, here goes nothing. Better hurry up and get into the dorms.
What?
What would I buy if I had enough money to build a whole dorm? Probably not a dorm. Now that I'm gone, Steph might be the coolest person left at Blackwell. Besides Rachel, obviously. Hey, Steph.
Whoa. Hey, Chloe.
Surprised to see me on parole?
I told you Wells was out to get you. That text was a rare courtesy, by the way. I don't normally get involved in other people's dumb decisions.
Trick's on you, because I am the ultimate lost cause.
Skipping with Rachel Amber does have an appeal.
Well, yeah.
So, what are you doing here?
I'm just picking up something from somebody. It's for a friend.
Now I'm really curious.
What are you doing? What's all this stuff?
I'm prepping for the Tempest show tonight. I'm the stage manager.
Oh, right. I think I knew that.
Honestly, the show's really good. It's worth seeing.
I'm sure it is.
Obviously, Rachel's fantastic, but everyone else is pretty impressive, too. You get to see a totally different side of everyone, especially the guys.
Okay. I'm intrigued. Go on.
Like, Hayden's so annoying, but when he puts on that crown, he's actually very princely. And Nathan as Caliban? There's so much depth there.
Right. Depth. Yeah, well, good luck with all of that. Maybe I'll see you later.
Oh, hey. I wanted to ask you something.
Shoot.
I've been planning to make a move on Rachel, but not if you two were together.
Make a move?
So, are you? I mean, that's Rachel's business. Or maybe yours and Rachel's business. But if you feel comfortable telling me...
I don't know. It's confusing.
Yeah, I can imagine. You ever want to talk to me, Chloe, you know you can, right?
I'll see you later, Steph. Locked. Figures. Looks like my options are become a master lockpicker or swipe someone's keys. Bingo. If only those keys were unsupervised. What's Samuel working on? The sprinklers? How do I get Samuel out of there? It looks like he's working on the sprinklers. Everyone followed that bird off a cliff, but I'd settle for away from the sprinkler. Evan's subject for the day. Better you than me, bird. If Samuel's working on the sprinklers, some damage here might get his attention. But Evan is right there. The other way. Time for a fresh start. Here we go.
Like I said, we're going to get that message quite a lot.
Now I just have to wait for Samuel to turn on the... That works. Sorry, Samuel. All right, time to find Drew's room. Such a nice white door. Definitely cheers the place up. No time like the present.
To see you and all, but what are you doing here? Didn't you just get expelled?
Relax. I'm just visiting a friend.
I really can't just let you go in.
Come on, Skip. I break the rules, and you think it's awesome. Let me break this rule. For old time's sake.
I want to, Chloe, but I really can't.
I'm going inside, dude. You're just gonna have to let this slide.
I don't think I can. In fact, I think I have to ask you to state your official business or else vacate Blackwell property.
I hate to do this to Skip, but
I've got to get inside. Maybe if I make him really uncomfortable, he'll feel guilty and let me pass. What's my official business? Like it really matters? I don't have to tell you anything.
Chloe, I just have this feeling like you're up to... Wait. You talked me into letting you into the bathroom this morning, and then you tagged the entire friggin' place.
What? No, fuck it. I totally did that.
Wells raked me over the coals for that. Time to go.
Or what? What are you gonna do, Skip? Because unless you're prepared to drag me off this campus, I'm going inside.
Chloe, enough. This is my job. Just go. You have never respected me. You and all your smug little classmates. I am so tired of being shit on by high schoolers. You know what? I'm done. I'm done with this stupid rent-a-cop job. Just do whatever the fuck you want, Chloe.
Oh, Skip.
Matthew, I've gotten reports of an unknown vehicle in the parking lot.
That's funny. Because I've gotten reports about how your head is really far up your ass.
What did you just say?
Damn. Skip really lost it there. Which one is Drew's room?
Oh, wow.
Could Elliot be lamer if he tried? Elliot Hampton's room. Wonder what he's up to right now. Work really hard. I guess I'm happy for him. I knew Elliot did well in class, but I didn't realize he was here on a full ride. Elliot's mom seems nice.
Lucky Dana.
Warren Graham is such a nerd.
Oh, I know.
There's way less porn here than I would have thought. Wow. I remember this show. Crazy that Elliot would hold on to this picture after so long.
That's not half bad.
Okay. Dark. Who is it that Elliot's writing about? Elliot is way more artistic than I thought. Wait, are these about me? What the fuck, Elliot? The world breaks everyone, and afterward, some are strong at the broken places. Why does that make me sad? That is really gross. I wonder what Max would think. Yep, definitely Drew's room.
It's a code that we need to find. Oh god dang it.
Good. Drew's not here. Okay. If I were Drew, where would I hide? Is the money in there? Alright. Guess I have to crack a 4-digit code.
Guys, if you could just give me 1 second here.
I didn't realize Drew was this good at sports. I bet he can't wait to get out of Arcadia Bay. Frank wasn't lying. Looks like Drew sells happy pills to his fellow meatheads. Bad guys? Awesome. Looks like Mikey's been staying here with Drew. A lot of numbers on here. Would Drew really use something like this for a lock combo?
Okay, so let's just go back to the lot. I'll put the code down below if I remember. If not, then tell me in the comments. Won't do it. Well, I pressed B instead of pressing A, god dang it. Okay, let's do this properly. Big choice coming up soon.
This is kind of fun. Did little Drew beat you up too? Jackpot. I'm kind of good at this. Bust out of here.
Hey, Mikey.
Chloe, what are you doing here?
I was looking for your brother, but he's not here, so.
Why? Bro, we gotta go. What are you doing here? Doesn't matter. Mikey, get your stuff, let's move.
Drew, relax. Slow down.
Shit.
You're making me think you're nervous about something.
Who the hell is that?
No one. Stay in here and don't say anything, little brother. Whatever you do, don't open the door.
You know what's going on?
Damien, you shouldn't have come here. School's not the place for this.
Really? Where is the place to collect my fucking money?
Shit.
I told you, I don't have it. Sales are down, man. Nobody wants to get high right now. But look, it's free season. We just started 2-a-days. Those are gonna kill us. I'll be able to sell all the oxy you've got.
Drew, you owe me a grand. Where is it?
I said I don't have it right now. I heard about your dad's job, by the way.
This guy's a dickhead, not Drew.
Yeah. Bet a grand would mean a lot to him right now. Where's my money, Drew?
I don't know what you expect me to do. I can't just make money appear out of thin air.
No, I want my fucking money!
You don't have to hit me, man. I'm gonna...
Where is it?
Please! Just give me 1 week!
You're just going to lie there?
I thought football players were supposed to be tough.
Sorry to have to do this, kid! No one steals from me!
Fuck!
Give Damien the money, stay with Mikey. I'm gonna deal with what brother said, even though I hate it.
Let me go! No! Your brother said to stay inside. It'll be okay, Mikey. It'll be okay.
Damn, you were one tough kid. Fuck you. Yeah? What about this? Good luck running on that knee now. High five football. Well, I'm done. Get my money. Or maybe it'll be your little brother I talk to next. See you soon.
Drew! It's okay. I'm okay, little brother. Thank you, Chloe. Thank you.
I didn't do anything.
You kept my brother safe. Drew, you need to get to the hospital. Don't tell anyone about this, okay?
Yeah. No. No way. What? What are you going to do?
About Damien? I don't know. One day at a time.
I hear you.
Jeez. Episode 3 trailer came out today, 6th of December. Looks like something's gonna happen for that from this. Refrozen. Dormitories. Can't really remember what happens next, to be honest. So the that play next. That's all. Oh, this is next. Oh, I remember what's coming up now. Something with Victoria later on.
This day has been so messy. At least I can talk to Rachel now. if I can find her back here.
That's the dad there.
That's some shameless eavesdropping there, Samantha. Hey, Samantha.
Nathan, please.
I can't do it, Dad. I'm sorry.
Keep your voice down. Now listen to me.
You don't understand. They all hate me. They're just gonna laugh at me. And the football team will just bully me more.
Why do you suppose that is?
I don't know.
Because you show weakness. Just like you're doing right now.
Dad!
When will you learn that this isn't about you and your problems? This is about the Prescott name. My name. You will not embarrass me.
Jeez.
Nathan.
Yes.
Good. Now. Break a leg. I'll see you after the show.
Nathan's dad is some asshole, huh?
I know. I wish he'd just go away and leave him alone.
Nathan's dad sucks. But you should be careful what you wish for when it comes to parents.
Oh, Chloe. I wasn't thinking. I'm sorry.
For what? You didn't kill my dad. Or did you? That was a joke.
I know. Your dark sense of humor reminds me a lot of Nathan's. Actually, the two of you are really similar.
What the hell does that mean?
I'm serious. You're both artistic and surprisingly sensitive. You've been through a lot, and a lot of people unfairly judge you for it. Nathan's hurt, and he needs help. But whenever I try to help him, it always seems to make things worse. If you were Nathan right now, what would you want me to do?
Okay, but he won't like it. I'd want you to go away and stop bothering me.
Chloe.
Nathan and I aren't lovable rebels in some terrible 80s movie. We're messed up. You shouldn't be trying to help him because you can't, and you'll just end up hurt.
Do you really think that's true?
Yeah, I do.
That's really sad.
Good luck with that savior complex, Samantha.
Why is this the one that's going?
Did Doug dig?
Rachel?
Ah, that's the one. I get a bit mixed up when I do this. She's putting something in the tea. It's pills to make someone fall asleep or fall down faint, whatever.
Whatever that was, it was shady as shit. I need to find whatever Victoria's... slipped into that drink. Adding putting on makeup to the long list of reasons I wouldn't be caught dead on stage. Muscle relaxers?
Hurry now before your tea gets... What are you doing here? This area is for cast and crew only.
I'm here to support Rachel.
How nice.
I want to make sure she's relaxed before the show.
Whatever. Oh, Rachel Amber, it was customary among the thespians of ancient Greece for the understudy to offer hot tea to the lead actress on opening night, as a way of showing appreciation for her tutelage. It is in that spirit that I offer you this beverage. May it help to reveal the essence of your talents for all to see.
Wow. That, thanks. Wait up, Rachel. Bitch, dosed your teeth.
Excuse me? How dare you?
Victoria, could this possibly be true?
Of course not. A dropout Chloe is clearly directing her misplaced anger at me. I'm sorry your life is a mess, but it's not my fault, okay?
Chloe, Victoria is my friend. She would never do anything to sabotage me. Then she should prove it. Drink the tea.
What?
I wouldn't dare insult Victoria's integrity like that. Then again, if that's what it'll take to convince you that Victoria is a good and caring person, fine. Come on, Vic. Put dropout Chloe in her place once and for all.
She did do the pills.
Oh, happy?
So happy.
Ugh, whatever. If you're done accusing me of things, I'll just be on my way. Bitches.
Wow. Saved my ass again. Price. All in a day's work. And this has been a particularly batshit crazy day.
We're ruined. The show is ruined.
That was quick.
My dear young artists, a misfortune most unkind has befallen us. Juliet is waylaid. That infernal inferno is the culprit, closing down the roads and robbing us of our Ariel. Would that she could but manifest on her master's whim as a true spirit. Alas. Devoid of an understudy, the situation is a dire one indeed. I'm afraid we may have to cancel. Truly, we are a cursed lot. Even my prodigious imagination cannot conceive of a worse turn of fate.
Pa!
Touché.
Is that it? Not gonna give a shit.
What?
Oh, no.
Mr. Keaton.
No.
Chloe could step in for Juliet.
No fucking chance.
At least until the road's clear.
The cynic.
She's the right fit for Juliet's costume.
She is indeed. Tell me, my dear, have you ever acted before?
Hell
No.
She's being modest. We play improv games all the time. And she's fantastic at it.
My dear, what if I told you that the entire fate of the production rests upon your slender shoulders?
I'd say you're super fucked. Chloe, please. For me.
And she doesn't.
Damn it.
That always makes me hard, that does.
I can't believe Rachel's talked me into this.
You look nice. You look nice. Anyway, thank you guys for watching this part, and I'll see you on the next one. Hopefully I can get episode 2 all done before episode 3 comes out. Peace!